In the United States, there are more than 3 million kids participating in gymnastics. The ones hopeful for a professional future dedicate an average of around 30 to 40 hours a week in the gym. According to an MIT study, gymnasts dedicate more time to their sport than any other athletes before entering college.
Okay, I wake up about 6:45, breakfast, get ready for gym, warm up, stretch, all that at gym, do my first workout, and then we have a break. I do schoolwork, eat lunch, and then the second workout's longer and harder, usually like bigger skills, more routines. And then I come home and I do any schoolwork I haven't completed at the break earlier, and then I just hang out for the rest of the time. I'm in the gym for 30 plus hours a week.
Okay, so when I was little, so from like 7 to 11, I would do 3 hours Monday, Wednesday, Fridays, and Saturdays. And then I would do 6 hours Tuesdays and Thursdays. And then when I became elite, I did about 6 to 7 hours every day, Monday through Saturday. And no vacations, you know, no time off, 2 days off for Christmas, if even that.
But long hours in the gym aren't enough to get girls to the Olympics or elite level competitions anymore. It's becoming increasingly necessary for girls to begin gymnastics at younger and younger ages.
I started gymnastics when I was about 2 years old with those mommy and me classes. I was really hyper, and whenever we went to watch classes, I would always want to get out on the floor and like I would pull on the bars, and so my mom finally put me in.
I started gymnastics when I was about 14 months old. When I hit about 3, that's when like my mom and all the other coaches realized I had a talent for it, so she put me in it, and I've stuck since.
Gymnast Nadia Comaneci ushered in a shift in the ages of Olympian gymnasts. In 1976, Comaneci secured the gold in the all-around at just 14 years old. Prior to 1976, women winning the all-around had been in their mid-20s and even their 30s. Since then, the average age of an all-around champion is just 17 years old.
I mean, if you're looking to be competitive, then I would say like 7 or 8 would even be too old to try to progress to the Olympic age.
I wanted to be an Olympian, but then I realized how hard it was.
That was always my big goal, and that's why I went elite. And then when I became an elite, I always knew I did want to do college gymnastics also. So that was like my second goal after the Olympics.
When I first started, my goal was to go to the Olympics like any little girl, but it changed as I got older. Changed because I realized it wasn't realistic and I didn't want to be an elite gymnast because it didn't seem as fun. I wanted to do college gymnastics.
At least 10% of the kids that we have the ability and desire and the work ethic to achieve that goal. It's just in the U.S. it's just so hard, you know, because we are the top country in the world, and they usually only take the top 5 or 6 kids. So yeah, it's very hard, but we definitely have girls that can achieve that goal.
There's 16, 17 year old, 18 going into the Olympics representing a country. They're kids, and then all the other sports, they're adults. So it is a lot harder for gymnastics because they do only take 5. You're demanded so much mentally and physically from when you're 12 to when you're 17 on your body, and you're becoming, you know, your body changes, you turn into a woman from a girl. You are injured all the time. You're dealing with the pressure of the Olympic committee. It's just a lot, and a lot of people don't realize how much it is.
I think it's very unrealistic, and unfortunately, we can all have dreams, but you know, I think it's unrealistic, especially at a young age, to put that carrot out there. I think it's a false expectation and builds a sense of false security.
Whether it's fair or not, it's been becoming more difficult to succeed at a level high enough to be considered for the Olympics or elite level competitions. Girls are dedicating even more time to perfecting skills, but more time in the gym means more opportunities for injuries.
And when gymnasts go through what they need to go through, there's a repetitive loading and unloading of forces across a joint. And over time, that can add up. So I would definitely say the more time you spend doing it, the more chance you are to get a repetitive injury, a stress injury, a sprain, a muscle tear.
And if you are this much off on the beam, you can miss your body and land on your leg. I've had an injury in my wrist where it was losing bone from the inside out, kind of. And I've had an injury where I tore all the ligaments in my rib cage and my collarbones, and I fractured my wrist.
My biggest injuries were fracturing both femurs at the same time and dislocating both elbows at the same time. Those were two separate injuries, but they both happened at the same time.
I tore the ligaments inside my spine because I landed a vault and I just kept twisting and it just kind of tore it. So I have to get epidural shots like every 6 months for it. And then I have scoliosis, so.
But gymnasts really drive themselves very hard. They do a lot of repetitive stuff and they don't often pay attention to the signals that your body is giving out that say you should stop, that this is an injury.
I've gotten MRIs and they've said my name, and when I stand up, they're like, no, we said Braie speed. I'm like, yeah, that's me. And they're like, we looked at this and this is the back. We've seen a back of a 9-year-old that looks just like this. Like, they thought I was 90. I was 14 at the time. I was like, yeah.
Now I'm in the doctor like all the time because I had more issues after gymnastics than I did in gymnastics, and they told me I'll be on like arthritis medicine by like the time I'm 35 just because of the joint issues that I have now.
But what may be more damaging than broken bones is the psychological effect gymnastics has on young girls.
They're confined to the gym, confined to coach and their cohorts in the gym. So their life is gym, go home, eat, homework, gym, and you don't have the cohort of meeting with friends and being walking in the hallway or going to a lecture or have the luxury of going to the theater or hanging out at the mall, which all teenagers should have the right to do. That's a problem.
I didn't do other things. I just did gymnastics. How was it?
Okay, but that mean that was my normal, but to other people's normal, like I was like, I don't have any friends. Like I have friends, but it's like, I don't ever get to hang out with them. I don't ever go on vacations. And I knew that's what I had to do in order to be that kid that everybody knew, you know, because you went to the Olympics, but this is what you have to do to get there. And it came to a point where I was like, I can't take it anymore.
You know, they're little, they're in elementary school, you know, they love to come to gymnastics, but then when they're missing football games or missing parties, you know, and they have to train instead of, you know, be with their friends, that usually is the cutoff.
I don't feel very normal most of the time. Well, normal people go to public school and then they come home and hang out with their friends and we're at the gym all day. And we do school for the break. We're kind of self-motivated. At public school, it's all like friends, drama, teachers, and at gym, it's more get it done.
I think the way they approach their peers, the way they interact with their friends, relationships, all those I think can be hurt because they're not a well-rounded person.
I like learn differently than a lot of people because I didn't go to public school and I was homeschooled. And I don't know, it's just like you grow up differently and you don't have like the same things to relate to other people. Like when people talk about going to elementary school, like I never really got that, or just like average stuff. Like I never got to really be a kid. I never got to go like ice skating on the weekends or go on vacation or I didn't go to Disney World until I was 13. So that was that.
Oh yeah. My old gym at Ariel's, they all went to public school. The girls would come in for a gym and they're like, I got 3 hours of sleep. And then they're stressing out at gym because they have so much schoolwork left or they've got this huge test. And so I was just like, thank God I don't do public school because I get stressed out really easily. So I was like, I would be bald.
It's a lot of fun, so I think it's worth it, but I really don't miss being under that much pressure all the time. However much you train and then relying on that one moment, those few seconds or a minute or two on an event, it's stressful, and you don't want to let yourself down or your team down, especially in college. Like, it's a team thing, so letting your team down, it feels bad. So
I had to get top seven to make it to nationals, and I had all this competition, and just the month training up to it, I was just so hard on myself and like so freaked out if I missed, you know, one, if I fell on one thing. So I'm like, if this happens in the meet, I'm not gonna make it. Well, the week before regionals, I had always done really good. I had been doing so good on beam. Like, I was like, I can do this. And I hadn't missed like one side aerial between warm-ups in the gym, competitions in the gym, and then the warm-up at the meet. And I fell on my side aerial in my competition routine. And I, like, as soon as my feet hit the floor, I was like, I'm not going to nationals. So I was like, and I got off a beam, and I was like, this is the most unfair sport I've ever heard of in my life. Because, you know, it's the old saying, tennis, you got two serves, you know, baseball, you got three strikes, gymnast, you really only have. I don't care what you've done in the gym for the past 15 years. It's what you can do now. If you mess up, too bad for you.
Why then, after all the injuries, the falls, the stress, the sacrifices, the unfairness, do so many girls decide to stick with it, even if they know they'll never make it to the Olympics?
I just stuck with it because I loved it. That was pretty much simple as that.
It's your life. I had never been to public school. I'd never really known another way other than gymnastics. So to me, that's all there was. I only had one teacher. I only had a couple friends, and I only went to gym every day. I didn't have another life, so I didn't really know anything else. And that's probably why I stuck with it for so long, and probably why so many other girls stick with it for so long.
It's just fun, and I like doing it. It's gives me adrenaline. It's just fun.
I just loved it. I mean, I guess because it had always been a part of me. I had actually quit gymnastics when I was about 8, and it only lasted for about a week because I was like, I really miss it. I was like, this has just been a part of me. I couldn't imagine giving it up. So, and I knew in the long run something would come out of it, whether it was, you know, the Olympics or a scholarship, so.
Although Braie did get something out of it, she recently committed to the University of Arkansas gymnastics team, the majority of the more than 3 million kids in gymnastics will not. From 1981 to 1982, there were 190 colleges with NCAA gymnastics teams. Today, there are only 75. But the future of gymnastics is not bleak. Even if girls don't achieve professional advancement, the valuable life lessons like time management and determination that gymnastics instills will stick with them for a lifetime.